This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Recently at the Microsoft Online Tech Conference called Microsoft Ignite, they had a session that reminded me how much Windows 10 has changed over the years. I've often seen enterprises indicate that they are on a certain version of Windows 10 or a feature release and they haven't moved on to that. Or they've decided to roll out long-term servicing branch and they've never revisited that decision. If you're like many in tech, you kind of hover on the advantages of certain releases and you don't really remember over time how much Windows 10 has changed. So let's give a little refresher of what Windows 10 has done over the years. And I want you to ask yourself, why are you on the version that you're on? 2.0H2 is out. And I don't want you to have to justify why you're on that one, because I don't think you need to be on that one quite so soon. But if you're still in the 1800s or 1903, is there a really good reason that you're on that older version? So let's do a little bit of a history lesson. 1507. You remember way back when the Windows 10 was first released to manufacturing? That had Windows Defender, Windows Hello, the first passwordless login, Microsoft Edge, yes, the old one, Device Guard, BitLocker, and Smart Screen technology. It included support for in-place upgrades, Cortana, and it's still under support for enterprises and Internet of Things Enterprises long-term service branch edition. 1511 added mobile to device management, group policy settings for the Windows Update for Business, as well as Azure Active Directory Join. 1511 is no longer serviced, and I hope no one is on that version. 1607, which is still under support for Enterprise and Internet of Things Enterprise Long-Term Service Branch Edition, added Windows Information Protection, Windows Hello for Business, and Hybrid Azure Active Directory Join. Now we're up to the first quarter of 2017. How many years ago was that? 1703 added Windows Defender Advanced Threat Protection, one of my favorite features, and Windows Defender Security Center. 1703 at this time is no longer under support. 1709, third quarter of 2017, added Windows Defender Exploit Guard, System Guard, Application Guard, and Application Control. It is unsupported as of October 13, 2020, for Enterprise and Internet of Things Enterprise Long-Term Service Branch Editions. So now we're up to 1803. 1803 added fixes for Spectre and Meltdown. Do you remember those vulnerabilities in the BIOS updates? It also added Windows Delivery Optimizations, Windows Defender Advanced Threat Protection Automated Remediation, Conditional Access based on Windows Defender Advanced Threat Protection Device Risk, Threat Analytics, Emergency Outbreak Updates, Advanced Hunting, Cloud Credential Guard, and Windows 10 Enterprise in S Mode. I'll go over S Mode in a future edition of CSO Online. 1803 is supported through May 11th, 2021 for Enterprises and Internet of Things Enterprise Long-Term Service Branch Editions. We're now up to the third quarter of 2018. We started off with Windows Update packages being reduced in size in order to speed up the servicing and installation. 1809 added Microsoft Defender Advanced Threat Protection new attack surface reduction controls, investigation and remediation across Office 365 Advanced Threat Protection. Microsoft Edge added web authentication and Windows Hello added support for FIDO 2.0. Microsoft Edge added kiosk mode. 1809 drops out of support for Home, Pro, Pro Education, Pro for Workstations, and Internet of Things Core on November 10th of 2020. So that's your drop dead date for 1809, November 10th of 2020. If you're still on that version for those editions, ask yourself, why did you wait so long? You should be off of those by now. It's still under support for Enterprise, Internet of Things Enterprise Long-Term Service Branch Edition, and will be supported through May 11th, 2021. We're up to first quarter of 2019. We added Microsoft Defender Advanced Threat Protection Enhancements, Attack Surface Reduction Enhancements, Next Generation Protection Enhancements, Tamper-Proofing Capabilities, Windows Sandbox, and Application Guard Enhancements. Many of these, you need an E5 subscription in order to see the benefits of them. 1903 also added the ability to sign on with passwordless Microsoft accounts. Delivery optimization was also improved. For those of you running Home, Pro, Pro Education Pro for Workstation, and Internet of Things Core. The support goes through December 8th, 2020, so keep that in mind. You've got two end-of-life dates coming pretty close to one another. They got pushed off because of the pandemic, so you've got a November drop-dead date and a December drop-dead date. November drop-dead is 1809, December drop-dead date is 1903. Just recently, in 1909, the release introduced BitLocker key rolling support for TLS 1.3. This release is supported through May 11, 2021 for Home, Pro, Pro Education, Pro for Workstations, and then also supported through May 10th of 2022 for Enterprise and Internet of Things Enterprise Long-Term Service Branch editions. Now then, I challenge everyone, if you are on 1909 right now, and especially if you're on Windows 10 Pro, you need to be in your final stage process of rolling on to at least 2004. You might even want to test out 20H2, because remember, you can skip editions. Now we're up to the first quarter release for 2020, I should say. This introduced Application Guard for Edge and Office, Delivery Optimization PowerShell commands, and introduced Windows Autopilot Azure Active Directory Join with Virtual Private Networking. Very handy for those of us doing work from home and connecting in the pandemic. This release is supported through December 14th, 2021 for Home, Pro, Pro Education, Pro for Workstations and Internet of Things Core, as well as Enterprise and Internet of Things Enterprise Long-Term Service Branch Edition. Now comes the new kid on the block, 20H2. That's the new naming you need to get used to. It means the second half of the 2020 release. If you have an E5 subscription, you get extra goodness with Microsoft Defender Application Guard, which also supports Office. More Windows Hello options, modern device management, and it combines the servicing stack update and the latest cumulative update in one release. Now for the bad news. If you made the decision years ago to roll out long-term servicing branch on your workstations for whatever reason, there is no in-place upgrade path from long-term service branch to the normal release of Office. The normal release of Windows 10. You must start over and redeploy and rebuild the machines. Windows Autopilot can make it easier for you to roll out these Windows 10 to machines. But I really want you to question, why are you choosing long-term service branch? And also question, why are you holding back on an older release? Look at all the key features that you've lost out on along the way. The servicing stack updates, the ability to do better protection for your workstations. Advanced threat protection has come a long way since it was released. Windows Defender is much, much more powerful, and especially as the attackers are going after us much, much more. So it's time to step back, ask yourself, why did you choose the version you're on? Why did you choose long-term servicing branch? Why did you choose that certain feature release? Take the time to reevaluate and see why it's still a good decision to make today. I hope I've given you some things to think about. There's lots more things to research and look at on the IDG Tech Talk YouTube channel. Join me next time. This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online.